Today's show is sponsored by a former guest, the FinTech Group, and their solution for cannabis online companies and dispensaries to accept cashless payments. If you own a cannabis dispensary or a cannabis online business, you know that banking laws make it impossible for you to accept any form of payment other than cash. The FinTech Group finally provides an option that was previously not available. To learn more, go to fintechmerchantaccounts.com/marijuana-dispensaries or listen to Raising Cannabis Capital, episode 55.
Which is investments into biotech, tech, and real estate, the top three most profitable sectors of any industry, especially in cannabis. And you are correct, we do have 30% of those funds are earmarked to be invested back into minority communities.
From MJ Bulls Media, it's the Raising Cannabis Capital Show. I'm Dan Humiston, and on today's show, how this firm is helping minority-owned cannabis businesses secure funding to help them overcome some of the barriers that were created by the war on drugs. Today in Raising Cannabis Capital, we are joined by Heather Lawson Bradfield from the Totem Advising Group. Heather, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me here.
Well, one of the great things about the cannabis industry is that it's still really a blank canvas, and it gives us a rare opportunity to do a lot of good things, including making an industry that's fully inclusive, because a diverse industry is not only fair, it also makes it a lot stronger. Unfortunately, just the demand to survive is so great that it's easy to lose sight of the bigger picture. And that's why it's so nice to have a company like yours whose foundation is built on giving minority communities the tools and guidance they need to help them succeed. I'd like to start there today, if we can. Can you just give our listeners a brief perspective of some of the sort of unique challenges that aspiring minority entrepreneurs face, and then some of the ways that you help them overcome those challenges?
Absolutely. Thank you so much. That's a great synopsis of exactly why we do what we do at Totem Advising Group. So we are a minority-focused business development marketing firm in the cannabis space. And we are minority-focused because, as you mentioned, minorities tend to have a greater challenge of becoming successful entrepreneurs in any business space, but especially in the cannabis space, historically because of the war on drugs, has disproportionately affected the Black and Brown communities. And so what my firm does is focus on extending a hand out to help pull people up and open doors so that they can experience the opportunity of successfully running their own company or firm or online venture, e-commerce, or whatever that may look like in the cannabis space. Mm-hmm. So we achieve that through a couple of different mechanisms. Primarily, what we do is we put our money where our mouth is. We represent these communities. We have women leaders. We have African-American leaders. We have non-able-bodied individuals. We have veterans. We have the spectrum of individuals that comprise our company so that we can represent the people that we want to work with. Another way that we do it is by being creative in how we bring on clients. Most times, the greatest challenge for an entrepreneur is achieving capital. So getting the funds or finding a way that they can actually launch their project, again, because of many socioeconomic structures that are out there, which disproportionately affect minorities. What we do is we work to be creative, whether that's through creating equity bids or finding investors that want to have an active seat at the table at a company that they can mold as well and create a mentorship environment, or find unique partnerships with other individuals that are interested in furthering the cause of individuals in this space that we just want to see it do so much more with the representation of individuals at the table.
Well, under that same heading, you recently teamed up with C.E. Hutton to help them really ramp up their Legacy 5280 partner fund. I had C.E. on the show a while ago, and for those of you that haven't had an opportunity to listen to that episode, for one, you should listen to it because it's great, but the 5280 Partnership Fund is an equity fund that mandates that a portion of all the investment goes to minority-owned businesses. Can you tell us a little bit more about the partnership?
Correct. Absolutely. So again, as I mentioned earlier, we really try to walk the walk and talk the talk at the same time. So C.E. Hutton is another minority-focused business development firm located out of Denver. And we became acquainted with one another when it became apparent that we had very similar end goals and objectives. And so we partnered in creating this venture capital fund, Legacy Partners 5280, which is investments into biotech, tech, and real estate, the top three most profitable sectors of any industry, but especially in cannabis. And you are correct. We do have 30% of those funds are earmarked to be invested back into minority communities. Our definition of minority communities are veterans, non-able-bodied individuals, LGBTQ, women, people of color, and any other minority group that we see within this country. We have this set up this way so that we can ensure that there is a door opened for an individual and they can pass that on. And then we begin to see this legacy of generational wealth be created within minority communities that haven't typically had these opportunities in the past.
It's so important. It's so important. And you know what's interesting is that I'm seeing this on our end is that we're having investors reach out to us who are actively seeking minority-owned businesses so that they can, for lack of a better word, correct their portfolio, making their investment right. portfolio reflect the population. That wasn't a thing a year ago, but it's definitely becoming a thing.
Yeah, absolutely. We do specialize in the minority space. And so I think our opportunity to see individuals walk through the door and say, hey, it's really important for me to ensure that I have the right team in place or I have the right portfolio makeup. And really understanding that that diversity is critical to be able to weather the long-term storms of investing. We find it, again, very important to help the communities that we're in understand that while you want an investor, you don't want to be sacrificing the majority ownership of your company along the way. That's one of the big problems that minorities run into when they're working to raise capital or gain capital. And so as we begin to correct this, as you said, correct this portfolio imbalance, that's another piece of the narrative that we're working in here to make sure that the investors and the investees understand how they can best work together and create that diversity, not just in the portfolio, but again, in the cannabis space in the long term.
I want to take a quick break to thank all of our Raising Cannabis Capital listeners and to remind you that you can support the show by subscribing to MJ Bulls Premium. It's only $4.99 per month, and you gain access to all previous Raising Cannabis Capital episodes, as well as all other MJ Bulls produced podcasts and exclusive content, including companies' investor pitch decks. Go to mjbulls.com and enter promo code RAISING to get your first month free. If someone wants to correct their portfolio, they can do so by investing in the Legacy 5280 Partner Fund. Are there any investment parameters that they should be aware of?
Yes. Thank you for bringing that up, actually. So we do work with accredited investors only. Not to say that we would ever turn down anybody that wanted to donate to the fund, because you're more than welcome to donate. This is really about a movement and about changing the landscape for the long term for generations to come, which is why we've named the fund Legacy Partners. It's about finding those legacies with the right kinds of partners. So we do also have a $50,000 minimum investment to the fund. All of this information can be found on our website if you'd like more information.
That's great. We'll have all of Heather's contact information and the Legacy 5280 Partner Fund. So we've been speaking with Heather Lawson Bradfield from Totem Advising Group, TAG for short. Heather, I really appreciate you being on the show today. And also thanks for everything that you're doing. This is such important work. Thanks again.
Thank you so much. I appreciate you having me here and giving me the opportunity to really speak about what we're doing and the changes that we're working to inflict for all of the individuals that deserve to have a seat at the table in the cannabis sphere.
Right time, right place. Let's just make it happen. Good luck.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Thanks for listening to Raising Cannabis Capital. To learn more about today's guest or to become a guest, visit our website at mjbulls.com. Today's show is produced by MJ Bulls Media, with original music produced in part by Jamie Humiston. I'm Dan Humiston, and you've been listening to the Raising Cannabis Capital Podcast.